Now that we understand nucleophilic addition to carbonyls, I want to focus in on one of the most important nucleophiles of all that can react in nucleophilic addition, and that's organometallics. So guys, I know organometallics freak a lot of people out. They look weird, they've got a lot of atoms on them, they're metals. But guys, these are some of the easiest compounds to work with in terms of pushing arrows, because organometallics are just really strong nucleophiles. So we're gonna do the same things with them as we would normally do with anything that has a negative charge, okay? Now, organometallics do tons of different reactions. So if you want to thoroughly review organometallics, you should go back to that section of your text. I mean, or of clutch videos. I've got plenty of videos on them. But what I'm gonna focus on right now is just really a refresher of what they do to ketones and aldehydes. So remember that we can use the letters R and M to represent any organometallic, because there's always going to be some kind of R component, some kind of alkyl group, and some kind of metal. The two that are the most common in this section are Grignards. So Grignards would be RMGBR. That would be a Grignard. I'll write it down. And organolithiums, R. IL, super easy. And that's an organolithium. Okay? And guys, these molecules are both extremely similar in how they react, because they both have that ionic bond with an extremely strong dipole towards the R. Okay? Because remember that in your periodic table, the further you go towards fluorine, the more electronegative you get. Well, carbon is actually pretty close to fluorine, whereas these group 1 and 2 metals are some of the least electronegative atoms possible. So it's going to be a very ionic bond towards the carbon. Okay? So ionic, in fact, that we can write these things ionized. Okay? We can actually write it as as R negative, MgBr positive. And the same thing for organolithium. We could write it as R negative, Li positive. Cool. So that being said, these are just both a source of R negative, okay? When that R negative sees the carbonyl, we're just gonna do nucleophilic addition. We're gonna attack the partial positive carbon, move the electrons up. What we're gonna get is a tetrahedral intermediate, O negative, R1, R2, but now I have my new R group, I'll just call it R, since that's the one that I just added. And, I mean, that tetrahedral intermediate would normally stay there, but these are usually followed by a protonation step. So, I don't know exactly what the protonation step would be, but I'm just gonna put some kind of HA, some kind of protonation would occur, and you would get your substituted alcohol. Okay, so you get OH, R1, R2, and the R that we actually added, okay? So that's just a reminder, guys. You should have worked with organometallics before in this course, but this is, you know, in case you forgot, this is really what you need to know for this section. You need to know how to add an organometallic to a ketone and to an aldehyde. You're always gonna get an alcohol product, and you're gonna get a new R group attached to that tetrahedral carbon in the middle. So that being said, why don't you guys take a look at the molecule below and try to do the whole reaction, draw the mechanism as well, and then I'll show you guys the answer. So go for it.